Next, let's specify the mesh. And in the meshing step, we are not affecting the mathematical model, we are affecting how the mathematical model is going to be solved. In particular, we are going to mark out the points at which we want answers to calculate the displacements directly. Go back to the project page and highlight model. You can double click on it or you can right click and select edit. And this brings up answers mechanical. So here we can mesh, we can put boundary conditions and get the numerical solution, do the post-processing. So the rest of the time we are going to be in this window and highlight mesh. And the geometry is a little hard to see, so I can click on Z. I can zoom out using the middle mouse wheel. And if I highlight line body, okay, I can see that a little bit better. Okay, so those are the midlines of the truss members we have. And so highlight mesh in the tree, and we are going to mesh it with one element each, and I'll explain that. So what I'll say is mesh control sizing, and I want to place sizing on lines, so make sure the line or edge selection filter is selected over here. And then you can just, you know, drag the mouse over the three, or the cursor over the three lines to select them, and then come here and say apply. And for type, I will say number of divisions, and I'll set that to one. And this is, you know, this means that Ansys can kind of modify this number, which I don't want it to do. I'll say, hey, you know, this is a hard setting. You do this only for simple geometries. For complex geometries, you just give it a guidance. You know, it's a soft setting. And but here I just want one element. And so let's see the effect of that. So I'll say update. What that's done is it's marked out the points where it's going to calculate the displacements directly, and these are called the nodes. And let's highlight that. So if I go to mesh, by the way, if you see these, you know, it's really only the midline, and I can turn off this in the view. If I go to view and say don't put the cross section over the line, so the mathematical model only has a midline. So okay, Ansys will let you visualize it in different ways. And if I go to, you know, if I select node, and this was this in 18.1, this or 17, you know, this looks different. In earlier versions, this option looks slightly different, and I can mark out the, you know, I can select the nodes. So if I move the mouse over, whenever it's near a node, it'll highlight it. So I have three nodes. Essentially, this means that it's at these three nodes that it's going to calculate the displacements directly. Okay, and if I go to statistics over here, it says six nodes. That's not right, because it's also counting the mid-side nodes, which it actually doesn't put in. So it's a defect in how it's reporting this for line bodies. So I can say, you know, I really have only three nodes, and that's over there. And I want Ansys to calculate the, you know, it, let's say this is UCX, how this node will move in the X and Y direction. Now I can put nodes in between two by changing the sizing. And for this, you know, if you have only axial extension or contraction, it's all linear, so it doesn't make sense to put intermediate nodes. But if you have bending, it makes sense to put in intermediate nodes, and we can increase the sizing, and we'll do that later. But right now, we'll just go with these three nodes. And if I write out, and from this, you know, we can figure out the number of algebraic equations to be solved and so on. But we'll get to that later. So that's all there is to meshing. So I can just go back to single select and then I can say file, save project. Let's go back to the specification, the mathematical model. The only thing we have specified so far is the geometric parameters. Let's complete the specification of the mathematical model next.